fire right now. Believing in what God can do if we just got the faith. Now, if everyone would bow your head right quick. Father God, in the name of Jesus, God, we want to thank you right now. God, we thank you for another day, God. Thank you for life. We thank you for health. We thank you for strength. God, we thank you for God being God all by yourself, God. God, we believe in you today, God, and we believe what you can do and what you will do. For God, we ask you to enter this building today, oh God. Have your way in this building today, oh God. Move in your way, oh God. Oh God, show yourself today. For God, we are here waiting to hear from you. Send your word, oh God, in the name of Jesus right now. Touch everyone in the building right now, God, one by one and name by name, oh God. Give them their heart desire, God. You know what they're standing in need of. For right now, God, we decree and we declare, oh God, that you're going to move today. And you're going to have your way. Touch the man of God right now, oh God. Anoint him with the word of God. Oh God, do it right now in the name of Jesus, oh God. And God, we're going to give you the glory. Yes. We're going to give you the honor. Yes. And above all, we're going to give you the praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And amen.
You are, oh Lord. worship him. Hallelujah. Come on, let's receive our own Bishop Jerry Davis. Hallelujah.
Appreciate the Lord. Today's the head of my life, my Lord, my Savior, Jesus Christ. Thank and praise each and every one of you for coming out and sharing with us on today to help us lift up the name of Jesus. I welcome our streaming audience on today. We're here at 377 Valley Hill Road in the city of Riverdale. If you ever have opportunity to come out to a live service, please come. We exercise all the safety precautions. I got my mask right here. Just don't want to put it on while I'm talking to you. Amen? Amen. But we're certainly glad to have you. We're here at the 11 o'clock hour in our Life Builders class, and that's on Zoom online. And you can find that each Sabbath morning, that's each Saturday morning at the 11 o'clock hour at the pleasantplaceministries.org website. Amen? Amen, amen, amen. And at 12 noon, we start our live service here in the sanctuary. So come on out, be a part, let us see those faces that's behind that camera. Amen, 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 and amen. Today, I would like to share with you just a word, a short, brief word from the Lord. Amen. Well, it's just actually a lesson from the Lord. I was reading an article this morning from Reverend David Bast, I believe his name was. He wrote back in 2003. And he wrote from the subject of blessed to be a blessing. Blessed to be a blessing. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, many of us, we really don't know what that truly means from a biblical standpoint. Now, I love cliches, name it and claim it. Amen. Hallelujah. Believe it and receive it. I love that stuff. Hallelujah. Now, it don't always work, do it? No. Come on, tell the truth. No. Not, you know, it don't always work, but there's still some good to come out of it. Because if it take me out of a depressed state, if it change my attitude for the moment, a negative attitude, but if it give me a little hope, amen, and make it to the end of the week, amen, it's done its job, amen. Hallelujah. But you as a people of God, true Christians, I want you to listen, to abide in truth. Because truth stands the time. Yeah, truth stands the test of time. And I'm tycoon this morning. Truth stands the test of time. Listen, and eternity. That's why scripture tells us that in all thy getting, first get an understanding. Yeah, when you go out there and you named it and you claimed it, you better get an understanding. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. You believed and you went out there to receive it. You better get an understanding. Amen. Because it can cause you some great disappointment. Hallelujah. But if you put your life, if you align your life with God and in God's plan, and just know, because he does not tell you every detailed step of what you're going to go through, of what you're going to experience, but he will tell you, brother, everything is going to be all right. Yes. Amen. Yes. Amen. So that's how you don't have to flip out when things are not going well, because that's just today. But our God, when he made promises in scripture, and when he makes promises to you, we had a testimony just a few minutes ago about one of the junior pastors here, I guess you could say, was saying that God promised her something when she was coming into ministry. And here, 30 some years later, he has not failed to deliver. When God promised you something, when you abide in his word, if you abide in his way, amen, listen, it's going to happen. Rest assured in what he said. You can rest assured in what he says. Amen. Blessed to be a blessing. From the biblical standpoint, in the Bible, a blessing is depicted as a mark of God's relationship with a person or a nation. I heard somebody was talking this morning, talking about having a relationship with God. My goodness, you got to know him. And in order to have a relate, you have to spend time. Hallelujah. When a person or a group is blessed, it is a sign of God's grace upon them and perhaps even presence among them. To be blessed means that a person or people take part in God's plan for the world and humanity. Notice he did not say right here that being blessed meant somebody gave you a check. Selah. Meditate on that a minute. When you read throughout scripture, notice when they talked about the blessings of the Lord being upon you, that a house wasn't just signed over to you. Now, I'm saying these things because oftentimes we think, you know, we consider ourselves blessed when we are the received. In fact, the Bible says just the opposite. It is better to what? Give than it is to receive. And the scripture really outlines that and it shows that. But I want you to know today, in Christ, you are blessed to be a blessing. You are blessed to be a blessing. Now, don't allow the adversary to rob you of that which God has given you even from the beginning. I was so excited when the young lady was talking about, I read something over there and it clicked. And he gave Adam the ability to call those things, amen, to name those things. He said, whatever you name it, that's what it is. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. And when it clicked, you'll take it, you'll run with it. You click, it'll take, and it's run with it. But God had told Adam and Eve, he says, not to eat from the tree in the midst of the garden with the knowledge of good and evil. And immediately, the adversary came. And he said, I got to take that away. And he appealed to their senses, their carnal senses. I'm telling this devil that we fight, he's spiritual. And he says, hath God not said? He immediately goes and he tries to take the word of God and twist it. Take the word of God out of their mouth. He immediately tried to take the word of God, amen, taint it, amen, and render them powerless. And when it's, listen, the power is in your mouth. Speak it. Jesus said he could speak those things that be not as though they were. And when he did, it had to line up. God stepped out on nothing. And he said, let there be light. And then there was light. The adversary would take that out of your mouth. God, your Father. You have the same attributes as your dad. But you allow the adversary to take it from you, to render you powerless. Amen. And he'll replace it with some gumbo jumbo. Amen. So we have to get back in the Word of God. I promise you I won't be before you long. Amen. But I want you to show you. I'm going to show you from the very beginning. Amen. And just like I was just sharing with you, when God bless you to be a blessing, amen, he didn't bless you for you. That's right. He blessed you to be a blessing. Yes, he blessed you, amen, because he got your ear, but he blessed you to be a blessing. Turn with me, if you will, to Genesis 12th chapter, first verse. You have it, say amen. Now the Lord had said unto Abram, get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred and from thy father's house unto a land that I will show you, and I will make of you a great nation, and I will bless you and make your name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. I'm gonna bless you. Listen, I'm gonna make your name great. Listen, and you gonna bless others. You are going to bless others. I'm gonna bless them that bless you. Hello, somebody. I'm gonna bless those that bless you. Watch this. This is where you have to be careful, and you have to let your haters know. You owe it to your haters to let them know. He said, because I'm going to curse those that curse you. Now, secretly, if you curse a man's time, I'm telling you to stop it right now, because I can't do nothing about that. The word of God said, listen, you can't come against me like that. I'm telling you that for your own behalf. I'm going to tell you. I want to warn you now. Amen. This is the word. This is the word of God. Hallelujah. Watch this. And in thee shall all, you got to get this. In thee shall all the families of the earth be blessed. That's my family. That's your family. That's your family. That's your family. Blessed to be a blessing. Amen. That same blessing that fell upon Abram's life fell upon Isaac's life, his son. That same blessing that fell upon Isaac's life fell upon Jacob's life. My goodness. My goodness. Now, Abram left wealth to Isaac. But when we read in the story of Isaac, amen, Jacob acquired his wealth down in Haran. In fact, you all know the story that when Jacob went down in Haran, he went there running from his brother, Esau, who, listen to this, who in the moment was so upset with his brother because his brother received a blessing from his father that he vowed to kill him. He vowed to kill his brother in the moment the recipient of the blessings of God, listen, to promote a nation. God, in his infinite wisdom, according to his plan, took Abram amongst his people to raise a nation out of him, spoke into his life as the blessings fell, amen, to him, then to his children until his children's children. Abraham never met Joseph, but the blessing was on Joseph's life, just as God said he would do, amen, for his family. Until the whole nation, somebody said the whole nation. Until the whole world, nations would be blessed. And so here's the meaning behind all of this. He blessed them to be a blessing. Hallelujah. Blessed to be a blessing. Now they had some fun. You're talking about blessing, but they weren't always and didn't always do good things. Amen. Hallelujah. God knows man. God knows mankind. And that's why I say don't flip out. Don't flip out when somebody else is flipping out. Amen. Hallelujah. Because they hadn't gone through their process. This same brother that hoodwinked his brother Esau and his father, amen, some two decades later, with that matter still in his heart, is now returning home, and now he gets word that his brother Esau is coming. And the only thing he remembers is that Esau said, he's gonna kill me. them not knowing that God had prospered, first of all, Jacob down in Haran, amen, prospered him, his family, amen, children, wives, concubine, amen. Turning home, he meets up with his brother and he's terrified. But when his brother meets him, he's not thinking about murder at all. 2 decades ago, amen, he wanted to kill him, but now he could think of nothing greater but to wrap his arms around him and love him. Look at God and look at the process that God has taken both of them through until we meet again. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So he blesses us to be a blessing. And the story goes on and it continues, amen, throughout scripture, even up until now. Amen. We see Joseph's brothers throw him in a pit. Amen. But that was part of his journey. It did not take the blessings away from him. In fact, his pit, hallelujah, was en route to the palace. It was simply a part of the journey, positioning him for the day that was coming that they knew nothing about, that this same Joseph, whom God had separated just like he did Abram, pulled him away from his people, raised him up, made him second in command in Egypt, and he was the one that saved their lives when the great famine came. But he now knew, he understood, because of the relationship he had with God, he wasn't even mad anymore. Hurt, yes, people will hurt you, but understand it's part of the journey. He said, listen, you all meant it for my harm. But God, hallelujah, but God knew what he was doing. You meant it for my heart, you meant it for harm, but God meant it for good. Amen. Let me share this with you. Before I go, and I want you to turn with me right quick to Isaiah, if you can. Isaiah, the 42nd chapter. Turn over there and just hold for me right there. There were people throughout scripture that God had blessed. Listen, when they were in captivity, to be a blessing. You all remember over in 2 Kings where this little woman, the little servant girl, her town, her little city that she lived in, her little place that she lived in, this enemy nation had come in and they ransacked the place and they took her away as prisoner and they put the little girl in the house and that was, she did the little maid work, little servant work. And actually it was Naaman. You all remember Naaman. He was a commander in the Syrian army. Amen. Actually, you all need to really understand that he was an enemy to Israel. He was an enemy to Israel. But the Bible says God blessed him to deliver, hallelujah, Syria. But we have to understand that God's plan is to save everybody. That's why I told you, you're in my lesson every week. God's plan is to save everybody. So sometimes we can't figure it out. Sometimes Jonah was so upset, he would not go to Nineveh to preach. But God's plan, listen, is greater. Than how we feel about a situation. Hallelujah, because he knows the end from the beginning. He knows the process of the process here. Amen. He should be able to speak to you. Amen. And say, there's a process here. Hallelujah. You need to take your hands off. Amen. There's a process here. Oh, the prophet that prayed for Saul. Amen. Saul, though, but God, don't cut him loose. Lord, don't cut him loose. And then God told him, there's a process here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And his plan and his process is greater, amen, than the way we think. And this young girl in captivity, hallelujah, had a word in her mouth. Naaman was great, had all the phylactery, all the armors, and all the, had great king, excuse me, great general.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did.
But the Bible said, but he had leprosy. All of his fighting couldn't do nothing about that. All of his sacrificing to his God couldn't do absolutely nothing about that. All of his false start couldn't do anything about that. But there was a little slave girl in his house that opened her mouth and said, I wish, amen, that my Lord, hallelujah, could inquire. Back over there where I was born, you know, where I was raised. There's a prophet in town, amen, that could cure him from leprosy.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah. Don't dismiss folk. Yes. Don't dismiss folk because you think of their stature. Don't miss. Some of the smallest among us got a word in their mouth.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And she wasn't afraid to speak it. She wasn't afraid to bless. You got the same word. Hallelujah. But you think because of your circumstances. You think, listen, that you can't speak, that's the adversary. I remember disciples going up into the temple, and there was a man that was sitting outside that had been halt, lame, paralyzed in his legs for quite a number of years. And they walked up and they looked down at him and they said, silver and gold have I not, but such as I have, I got a word. Come on, I got a word. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, take up your bed. Come on, rise up. In Jesus, there's some things you got to speak to.
Yes.
And walk in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Y'all found Isaiah? Listen to this. Because God has given to us, we've been blessed with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Don't let anybody take you backwards. Hello?
Amen.
Don't let nobody take you backwards. Keep preaching the truth. Stay in the Bible. Stay current. Amen. Keep flowing through. Hallelujah. You can't read just the Old Testament. You got to read the New too.
That's right.
Amen. Hallelujah. Listen to this. This is something that stopped and something clicked. Chapter 42, I'm going to read about 10 verses. Y'all hold on with me. I'm going to speed it up. We're going to go from here. Amen. Thank you for staying with me that long. Hallelujah. Behold my servant whom I uphold, mine elect in whom my soul delighteth. I have put my spirit upon him. He shall bring forth judgment to the Gentiles. He shall not cry, nor lift up, nor cause his voice to be heard in the street. A bruised reed shall he not break, and the smoking flax shall not be quenched. He shall bring forth judgment unto truth. He shall not fail nor be discouraged till he have set judgment in the earth, and the isles shall wait for his law. Thus saith God the Lord, he that created the heavens and stretched them out, he that spread forth the earth and that which cometh out of it, he that giveth breath unto the people upon it and spirit to them that walk therein. Here we go. I, the Lord, have called thee in righteousness and will hold thine hand, and I will keep thee and give thee for a covenant of the people for a light of the Gentiles, to open the blind eyes, to bring out the prisoners from the prisons and them that sit in darkness out of the prison house. I'm going to step back just for a moment. He says, I will give thee for Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. He's talking about the Christ. He gave Christ for a covenant. Now, I follow the old covenant ways. You're going to get what the old covenant got. Amen. I will give thee for a covenant. Read down a little further. I am the Lord, that is my name, and my glory will I not give to another, neither my praise to graven images. Verse 9, I'm going to talk about somebody that's mentioned this earlier today. Behold, the former things have come to pass. What? And new things do I declare, before they spring forth, I tell you of them. The former things have come to pass. Amen. I'm going to tell you about the new thing. He says, even before they come. Hallelujah. The new thing has been done. We have to walk in it. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. There's a new covenant. Yes. Name is Christ. Yes. Hallelujah. Somebody says there's liberty, yes, in Christ Jesus. But the plan, amen. Hallelujah. Blessed to be a blessing that continues on. That's a part of the plan. God blesses me that I might be a blessing to you. And listen, and somebody, don't think small of, amen, the power that you have. Because just like the young lady, the little girl, the little servant girl, was able to be a blessing to the powerful, honorable in man's eyes. She was able to drop a word on him that would do for him. Amen. Nobody else could. There's a word in you. That's a word of encouragement in you. Amen. God has given some of you wealth. Amen. Not to hoard, but to share, to bless. Amen. There are many wealthy, wealthy, wicked people. It is. But you know what he said? I'm storing up the wealth of the wicked for the righteous. Hallelujah. He said, still in my plan. He's still in my plan. God still lay hold and lay claim to everything in the earth. He said, the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof. Hallelujah. Cattle on a thousand is cattle on a thousand here, they belong to me. Every gold in the earth is still mine. My goodness, my God. But some of us would withhold that which belonged to him. Do you hear me? We withhold. He talked about that over in Malachi. He said, will a man rob God? Will a man rob God? No. I bless you to be a blessing to some folk. Hey, I got some folk over here that you should have seen, that you should have contributed, that you should, at the minimum, you should have asked me what to do. You robbed me. You robbed me. In Malachi, he talked about tithes and offerings, that there may be meat in his house. He don't eat meat. But my people, that my people might have the needs met, that my people, I put it in your hands, that my people, the wicked turn their head and keep moving and keep going, but their day are going to come. That shouldn't be names amongst us. Amen? Hallelujah. I hope you've enjoyed this message. I want you to think about it. You were blessed to be a blessing. Listen, you're supposed to keep this economy, I mean this spiritual Christian economy, flowing. God's people should not be without. We should not lack. David said, I once was young, but now I'm old, but I never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. Hallelujah, because somebody kept the cycle going. Somebody kept the blessings going. And God blessed us, and we are blessed in the personage of Jesus Christ, who became our covenant. Amen. And just like the little girl who spoke a word, he gave his life for something, amen, that we could never attain, but blessed by it. And we thank you for it, dear Lord God. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.
An altar built, a table spread, a tree that grew, a life was spared. Between two thorns, justice was placed. Blood for the world, amazing grace. Oh, how I'm drawn to the cross alone, the place where mercy and sin atone, the place where my sins met therein. Everything changed there, the cross alone. New life begins there, the cross alone. A rugged piece of justice took a carpenter, a Christ that would give up his life in exchange for a world so lost. Claim his name, sing.
Oh, how I'm drawn to
the cross alone. Yes, it did.
Yes, it did.
I know it did.
Yes, it did.
Yes, it did.
Yes, it did.
Yes, it did. Now we want to sing a few hymns about the power of the cross, and I hope you help us sing it out there. Come on.
So I'll cherish
the song that I got saved on. I need everybody, wherever you are, open your mouth and declare it.